How are you doing? My name is Tommy Vance. This is the Friday Rock Show, not from the studio this week. We are going to spend a whole day with one of the, if not the heaviest band in the whole damn world. And a band that to any member of any rock fraternity anywhere in the world will become instantly recognizable. We're going to spend the whole day with Slayer. We're probably going to try and get him out of bed first, because, you know, rock and rollers don't get out too early, so we're trying to get him out of bed. And then we intend to take him on a bus and sightseeing around London and stuff like that. Then we're going to go to the gig. We're going to find out what the catering's like. We're going to find out what it's like backstage. And then we're going to watch him on stage and let you see Summer Slayer on stage as well. And if we're lucky, we'll also get to meet System of a Down and Sepultura, because they're on the bill on this world tour. Now, when it comes to rock and roll bands, sometimes it's a matter of just going into the city, getting in a taxi or the transportation, going to the hotel, from the hotel to the gig, and from the gig back to the hotel, onto the next city. They don't see a lot. Today and tonight, Slayer are going to see London from one end to the other, believe me, and we want you to join us. So first things first, into the hotel. Follow me. This is such a posh joint. I think I'd like to move in. But I don't know where Slayer are, so follow me, we'll try and find out. Excuse me, ma'am, have you seen a band by the name of Slayer anywhere?
No, sorry, never heard of them.
Oh, I guess I just have to wander around and ask people. You know what it's like, investigative television. Hey, fella, you seen Slayer?
Have either of you seen Slayer?
No.
You seen Slayer?
Not a chance.
Oh, my God. Follow me. Excuse me, have you seen Slayer?
Who?
See what I mean? Who? Have you seen Slayer?
Hey, pardon? What?
Pardon, do you know that band? I don't know. Excuse me, sir, have you seen Slayer?
I have not.
Have you seen Slayer? Suck. Don't blow. Well, with a bit of luck, we might find out something here. I mean, after all, ladies and gentlemen, it is guest relations. Excuse me, sir. Sorry to ruin your telephone call. I know you're on the phone to Domino Pizza, but have you seen Slayer?
No.
Do you think you could help me
Domino's
find
Domino's Pizza?
Yeah, well, one of them.
Does this look like Domino's Pizza to you?
Well, they all look the same to me wherever you travel. It's like McDonald's wherever you go in the world. Looks the same. Can you help me find Slayer?
No.
You're the most... It's just guest relations, man. Guest relations. You're supposed to help me find Slayer. You know, come on.
Well...
Come on. Here. Step this way, please, sir. And,
You got a knife?
No, I'll pay for your pizza. Don't worry about a thing. It's very nice of you to offer in such a genteel and terribly English fashion, may I say, old boy.
Does this guy follow you around all the time?
He does all the time. I owe him money.
You owe him money?
You know how it is in life, you know, cameramen, you owe him money, they follow you around all the time.
All right, where do you want to go?
I want to go where you want to take me.
That's a rather personal question. Making personal references here? Which way you want to go?
I want to go,
Where do you want to go see?
I want to find Slayer.
Okay, we need to find Slayer. Well, the only way we can find Slayer is to go straight down.
Straight down where? Straight down to?
Down to the bowels of hell.
Down to the bowels of hell. Oh, my God.
Hear the bell.
I hope we're insured, Tom. This Tom's man. Hit that button. Where are we going once again?
We're going to the hell.
To hell. Oh, thank God that's over. Oh, they get bored with all this promotion stuff, man.
I don't think this mic's working anymore.
Don't get bored with it, you know. I mean, I want to be at the knitting convention. What do you want to be? Like the Royal Ballet, right? But we have to do all
I want
this
to be
stuff.
At the sleeping convention.
He wants to go, oh, no, I guess you have to act for all these cameras and do all that sort of stuff all the time. It's tough, isn't it?
How much longer do we have to do this?
For the rest of our lives.
No, seriously.
This taping. Oh, this taping?
Yeah.
Oh, for about another 7 years. Hi. Well, everybody, you're on the Friday Rock Show here. Friday Rock Show, and
answer my question.
What was your question?
How long are we gonna tape for?
Well, we're gonna tape for all day and all night. But right now we have to meet Kerry King.
We gotta go find who?
Kerry.
Mr. King.
Mr. King.
Well, like I asked you earlier, can you describe him?
Well, handsome, debonair, good looking, talented, plays the lead guitar. Fantastic head of hair.
Wrong band.
Wrong band, but right hotel.
Yeah, right hotel.
Okay, Tom, come on. That's enough of this mucking around. Let's go find the guy. I don't know where he is either. Any idea where he is?
I have no idea, honestly.
Okay. Well, let's go. I tell you what, you go that way, and I'll go this.
Cool.
Hang on. That doesn't make any sense. He went that way. Christ! But Tom, the only thing that worries me really is the state that he's going to be in. Because I mean, it's a big night last night, you know, gigging, and there's the after-show party every night. Because I know you rock and rollers, you're never off the bottle.
Oh yeah.
Do you think he's going to be, you know, able to string more than 8 words together?
Well, let's see.
You can't.
What time is it? What time is it? See, these rock and rollers, you know, they stay up all night, so... Uh-huh. He's either awake...
Yes.
...or he's still asleep.
That's one hell of a series of amazing logical ideas you've just implanted in my head there, Tom.
Hey.
Should we go find out?
They call me a genius.
Okay, seriously.
So you seriously want to walk in?
I want to walk straight through this door. In fact, I'm going to. But I'm going to walk straight behind you, Tom, because you are going first. And this. And this is a major hotel. A major hotel that's looking after a major band. I just want you to scan around this room and see the luxury that Kerry King lives in here. When you get past Mr. Continuity here, the luxury that Kerry King lives in here in London. Look at that beautiful building over there. And the fact that he's broken every pane of glass in that building virtually by turning his stereo up. This is Kerry King's collection of CDs, ladies and gentlemen. Pantera. Kilgore, bands like that, Black Sabbath, Sepultura, who else have we got here? Judas Priest, of course. All of them, phenomenal bands, and heavy as hell. What do we have here? This is the book that Kerry King is reading, Keeper of the Genesis, A Quest for the Hidden Legacy of Mankind. Yeah, never heard of it. Step this way. Let's go over here now. Let's see exactly if there's any evidence on the bed. Absolutely no evidence of any nocturnal emissions whatsoever. More CDs. Check this watch out. Take a look at this. That is cool. That is so cool. Isn't it just the coolest thing you've ever seen in your life? But, Tom, where is the man?
I think he's right there. That's the gentleman you're looking for. But you never described him for me, so...
Good looking, debonair.
I don't know.
Handsome and asleep. But we're gonna wake him up right after
he looks
this.
Like a burly man.
Friday Rock Show, Slayer on video there. Now we're actually in the bedroom. As you saw, we progressed through the whole deal. We're now in the bedroom with Kerry King and Tom Araya, who are 50% of Slayer. Gentlemen, welcome to the show. And so far, may I say, Tom, your acting capacity has been absolutely amazing. I'm really proud.
Before you get a load of me.
That's what worries me. Shake my hand. I shook the hand, and it still moved. I can still move it. Didn't break, but it hurts like hell. Okay, what's it like on the road? You must get bored shitless. Hotel room after hotel room after hotel room.
Yes.
Very good description.
This is a cool one.
You been on the road before?
Not yet. What's the wildest place you've ever played? The weirdest place you've ever played?
We just got back from Turkey.
I was going to say
that. That's the first time, and it was odd because we've never been there, and they don't get that many shows there, I'm pretty sure. So when we actually did go, they're pretty wild.
Pretty crazy.
Really?
Yeah, there were like a little over 100 kids at the airport.
Oh, man.
They had to maintain them. It was pretty crazy.
It was like Beatlemania.
Yeah, it was really trippy.
Kids the same all over the world?
Same everywhere.
Slayer fans, all lunatics?
Yeah.
Because they're pretty heavy. I mean, they are. To anybody who would not be adjacent to heavy metal, and they walked into a Slayer gig, I think they go, "We are now in the bowels of hell and Hades."
Good chance.
Yeah. You know? Yeah, it's pretty crazy.
Especially these little shows in London. It's so hot in these places.
Yeah. Actually, the shows have been really cool here.
What about trouble? I mean, do you get a lot of trouble at Slayer gigs because of this, you know, this feeling of tension?
What do you mean, trouble?
Trouble in the crowd. I mean, people want to kick the hell out of each other. Or maybe kick the hell out of you or vice versa.
I think there's a bad seed in any given show you might go to, be it Slayer or Aerosmith. There's going to be 5% there that's there to cause trouble. You know, it doesn't have anything to do with the music. They're just assholes to start with. And, you know, you weed those guys out and everybody else is there to have a good time.
One thing that I always look at, and you must look at, but from a different perspective, is the way that security functions in gigs. You know, when
security at this gig has been slamming. Awesome. Yeah. They know how to handle this kind of gig. Mm. You catch the kids, throw them right back out into the crowd, you know. Shouldn't say throw them, they escort them to the side and let them get back out.
And that can't be the same everywhere, Kerry. I mean, there's got to be some territories where, if you like, the security guys are, well, they just... All they think is, we're going to smack somebody.
In the early days, definitely.
Yeah.
Early days, all the time. We'd stop songs and throw guitars down and chase security guys and say, what the hell are you doing, man? This guy didn't hurt you.
Like, what are you doing? what are you doing? What are you doing? You know, they're like, and it's like, dude, man, it's like, so I've combated that by, when I'm singing, I'm always scanning the very front row, but I'm also looking to see what security's doing. And if there's just one hothead in the bunch, the rest feed off him. So I've learned to pull the one that's causing all the trouble out, and the rest chill out.
Sometimes, like everybody else in life, you must go, I've had enough. I've been on the road for a year, 6 months, 18 months, most of my life. Get me off this train. Do you ever feel like that?
For a couple days. It's time to start up again. I'm ready to go. I've been ready to go home for a couple months. You know, well, we haven't been home, actually.
I was just gonna say, how long have we been out?
2 months. Mm-hmm. That's the last time we were home, and it's time to go. Time to relax for a while.
When you do go home, what do you do to chill out, to relax, to
nothing.
Enjoy your life? Nothing.
Ditto.
No hunting, nothing. Fishing, or building things and stuff?
Sleeping.
Just forgetting about music for a while.
Yeah.
Really? What about you, Tom? I mean, you started in the medical profession.
Yes, I did.
And do you still have an interest in it?
No.
Now he sings about killing people.
We're going to follow you around all day. And based upon what these guys have told me so far, they don't seem to get out a lot and see the cities that they actually play in. So we're going to show them, well, not the whole of London, because it's a pretty big city, but from the top of a bus, quite a lot of it. So stay tuned, because you're on a Slayer special here on VH1 on the Friday Rock Show. Chosen specifically by the two gentlemen there, we've got Henry Rollins, who's a liar.
Now I see the destructive power of a lie. They're stronger than truth.
And welcome back to the Friday Rock Show here on VH1, a very special edition.
We are going around
London on the top of a bus with Slayer, because they want to see things that are cultural, things that relate to the United Kingdom, things that maybe even relate to the way the United States is run these days. Because, let's be honest, the United States of America is basically formed entirely upon the way the United Kingdom was about 1600 and zilch.
It's part of America right there.
Excuse me, what do you mean that's part of America right there?
McDonald's.
American institution.
I can only use one mic, so what did you say, sir?
It's American institution.
McDonald's.
Yes, sir.
Would you care to take it back?
No, I like it here.
Has anybody done this for you before? I mean, to put you on the top of a bus, a beautiful sunny day such as it is, nice and warm, and shown you our cultural sights.
Isn't this typical English weather?
No.
No? Well, no, actually, no one ever has, so it's kind of nice. This could be cool. Yeah.
Okay, well, we're going to
see, you know, all the cultural things and stuff.
We're going to take you around and show you what our nation is based on.
Right.
You know, and all the heavy metal places like Buckingham Palace. Have you seen Buckingham Palace before?
I think so.
But you don't know so?
Don't know so.
Maybe you played there.
No, I haven't done that.
Well, let me show you first where we are. This thing that's coming up on that side there, this big sort of arch, which you can see just over there, is called Marble Arch. Marble
Arch. That's pretty ingenious, isn't it?
You like it. Now, the Marble Arch...
You guys make that up yourself?
No.
Say McDonald's.
Not McDonald's Arch. Marble Arch. The Marble Arch. Marble Arch is only opened for royalty. It's when they're late for work, they'll open the arch and let them through. That's the truth.
Is that why we went through there?
No, we can't go through in this bus. I'm sorry.
Royalty works.
My name's King.
Sorry, you don't qualify. And you might do if your name was Queen, that'd be different. Okay, but it's King, so you don't qualify, I'm afraid. Oh, hang on, I want to show you this. Beautiful, look at that beautiful piece of architecture there. Are you not impressed? You're looking the wrong way, Tom.
There it is.
That thing. Well, you know, there's some marbles right over there.
It's made out of marble. It's made out of first-class marble imported from Marble Land or somewhere, I don't know.
I don't think we toured it yet.
But, I mean, one day. The only problem, if you ever played there, you'd fracture all the marble, the noise that you make.
Well, that might be pretty cool.
Anything like that in your hometown?
My hometown? No, there's graffiti in my hometown.
What about your hometown?
No, there ain't nothing like that in my hometown. Not anymore.
Would you like to buy it,
Would I like to buy that? Where would I put it?
Who cares? Would you like to buy it? You know, just make me an offer and it's yours, and I have it boxed and you can take it home.
You can give it to me. I'll fit on my place.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, it looks like we just saw Marble Arch.
That's what I like to see. Slayer just brought Marble Arch. And here's Slayer on video before they got the arch. That was Slayer there on video and War Ensemble. You're watching the Friday Rock Show from VH1 in the United Kingdom on the top of a bus with Slayer, showing them the magnificent architecture of our wonderful feudal society. In fact, we've just shown them along here. All these buildings along here is where all the servants live that you know, work for the Queen. Are you impressed about that?
Are they oppressed? What?
No, are you impressed? That's impressed, Kevin.
Oh, impressed, not oppressed.
No.
Oh, no.
That's where all the Queen's serfs live, down there. That's the little people that serve her.
Well, what, she could put them in better living quarters.
You're joking, this is central London. It costs a fortune to live around here.
Well, she's got money.
Mr. King, we'd like to, coming into shot quite shortly, we're going to show you Buckingham Palace, which is where the royal family live. Now, we all know that Americans are very impressed by our royal family. Can I have your views about it?
Do I get to see the Queen?
Well, I mean, we could drive up to the front door, do you think, and do it. I mean, we could probably do it.
She's probably expecting me.
Yeah, well, I mean, she's got Rain in Blood, I think. Is it Rain in Blood?
I think I read that's her favorite.
It's a bit of a headbanger. I mean, with a crown like that, you can afford to be, right?
Yeah, if it falls off, you buy a new one, right?
Exactly, you know, or sell another colony here and there.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. Maybe you think she's coming to the show tonight?
I think it's coming to the show tonight.
She's got a personal invite.
Did you send one up?
Yes, we did.
Okay.
Just in case, Your Majesty, Slayer invites you to see the show tonight at the Astoria, where we're going to be with our cameras, you know, just doing it. Who would you say in America, in the United States of America, is the equivalent of Her Majesty the Queen, Elizabeth II, United Kingdom?
Hillary. She's the one that rules all, don't you know? Bill's out getting some.
She's watching The Office.
Getting some what, Mr. King?
Some sweet love.
It's like in a traffic jam now. It's rather typical of London, isn't it? I mean, let's just play a record. You wanted us to play a video? Not a record, a video. What is it?
Highway to Hell, AC/DC.
That's what we're on right now, Highway to Hell.
The tour bus from hell.
AC/DC, A Highway to Hell, here on the Friday Rock Show. The choice of Mr. Kerry King from Slayer. We're spending the whole day with Slayer, currently showing them the sights. Impressed with the building? Are you impressed with the building, Kerry? I mean, let me show you that bit there. That bit there, right? Obviously, he's really impressed with that building.
I like the statue better.
Okay, would you like to buy it?
Yeah, that'd look good in my front yard.
That's good. So far, we've sold them Marble Arch, and now we've sold them Buckingham Palace. In an average day, I know you say you sleep all the time, but I'm damn sure you don't. In an average day... What was that for? He's not well. In an average day, in the studio, how much do you lay down?
An average day. Well, you can't say what we lay down. It's more time. I think we spend an average about 8 hours. And we, 8 hours at takes. And within 8 hours, we could do two takes. Not two takes, but I mean two songs.
But can you do them to fruition? Could you finish two songs in that length of time?
No, because initially when we're in the studio, the first thing we do is try to lay down the drum tracks. And those usually take, on an average, about a week, week and a half, depending on how Paul feels about what he's playing and how he's playing.
But does he just sit there in the corner of a studio and bang, 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 with the engineer going, no, do it again, put the microphone a little further into the bass drum, a little further out or whatever? I mean, that must drive him insane. Not only him, but everybody.
Well, that's one of the reasons why you have Rick Rubin sitting on the outside of the window going, that was a really good take. You know what I mean? Otherwise, Paul would be doing a million takes of every song and not be happy with any one of them. It's exactly how it is. So you have Ruben outside going, that was great. And then Paul will sit in and listen to a couple of takes and go like, all right, cool.
Can I just interject? Houses of Parliament, ladies and gentlemen. The seat of democracy. Way before you ever had a country.
How's it going, Ben?
Way before you ever had a country, that's where it was.
Big Ben!
He winked, man. He winked at you.
Oh, he does? Where is he? No, he's not.
He's in the tower, Tom.
Where?
Oh, skeptical Americans. They just never believe you.
This was here before we were what?
Oh, before you were a nation. Before, when it was all like, you know, Indians.
It still works?
Still.
What, Big Ben? Of course it does. Oh, yeah, sure. Yeah. So you want to buy it? Sure. It's a beautiful clock.
Sure, that looked great. Actually, it looked great in like a big grandfather clock kind of thing.
Fantastic in your backyard.
Sold Tom something.
Well, I'll buy that one. Absolutely. But the problem is, try and get the money out of him. Actually, what I'd like out of you now is a choice. He's got a list of stuff here. Give us a choice. And while he goes down there and he digs out something from our list of wonderful videos here on VH1, God, he's taking his time, man. I'm supposed to.
I could do.
You had one last time. You had a Highway to Hell.
I got another.
I could do a few commercials now. But I think he needs some attention.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Are you ready? I got one.
Okay.
Aces High, Iron Maiden.
Aces High, Iron Maiden. Okay. Sorry, fella. You're too slow.
That's fine by me, man. Aces High sounds good to me.
And welcome back to the Friday Rock Show. It's a Slayer special that you're watching, wherever you happen to be watching. Thank you very much indeed for joining us. We're going to have Slayer on later in the show, as they are on stage at the Astoria doing some live stuff for us. But right now we've got them on top of a tour bus and we're taking them around London because we're trying to inject some culture. We're trying to impress them with the way that our country, the United Kingdom, has been constructed. And so far, as you can see, they are immensely impressed. Next up, it's going to be Nelson's Column.
What do you, that thing is?
What?
The big boy thing right there.
Big what?
The big hard on.
Boy, you know? Boing-oing right there.
Big boing-oing. I've never heard anything described that before. Sorry, Admiral Lord Nelson. Any idea who he is?
Nope.
Do you care?
Not really. But I'm sure you're going to tell me.
Well, he was the guy that ran our Navy for a while. We used to have ships, so we'd send out ships, and we'd steal other people's land and steal all their crops and, you know, generally transport half the people from their country to somewhere else.
He was a pirate.
Well, not really. He wasn't quite a pirate. He was actually legitimate.
That's what you just described, the pirate. Someone that goes and steals people and steals their things and steals colonies.
No, Tom, you don't get it, Tom. I mean, we have here in the United Kingdom or Great Britain, we have a double standard. You know, a double standard means way we say it's good. If we say it's good, it's good. And the same thing tomorrow can be bad, because we said it's bad.
So he was more of a Jolly Roger.
Bit more of a legal Jolly Roger.
I'm catching on. I'm doing good.
Would you like to choose a video? I'm ever going to get anything out of you.
You're going to get something out of me. We're going to hear Nirvana, Lithium.
Why?
Because that's just
that's
how I feel right now. I feel like I want lithium because I'm frozen.
And welcome back to the Friday Rock Show. We're going around London on a bus with Slayer just to, you know, show them what our city's like. And, you know, what this is the place that gave you The Who and The Beatles and, you know, bands like that. Yes, it is true, ladies and gentlemen. It was the British that invented rock and roll. But it was the Americans, and Slayer in particular, who sped it up and sent it back to us and turned us into a deaf nation. What do you think of the display of sort of Times Square, I suppose? This is really like Times Square.
Kind of. Kind of Times Square.
Bow to the McDonald's gods.
Say again?
This is where you bow to the McDonald's gods. You ready?
You're not sponsored by McDonald's, are you?
I think we should be.
Number of plugs you're giving them. The little old thing over there, that little sort of winged bit, is Eros, the god of love.
Oh, yeah.
So you'd like to know that.
Is this where all love happens?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Lots of love in Piccadilly.
Yeah.
Especially after 3 o'clock at night.
Piccadilly?
Piccadilly, yeah.
What's a dilly and who's gonna pick it?
I don't know, but I'm sure your autobiography will tell us, Tom. I'm sure it will. Just time to sort of head for the Astoria and put you guys into a soundcheck situation.
That sounds like the plan.
What are we gonna get in terms of the set tonight?
Well, it's the third night we played, so we're gonna kind of, We've been mixing the stuff up every three nights, so tonight's going to be kind of a culmination of both sets from the last two nights, plus maybe a song or two we haven't done yet, so it's different because I'm sure some of the guys are coming to all three shows.
Loyal fan base, wherever you play.
Yeah, so, you know, we're trying to make it a little different every night for the ones that do come all three shows.
Of all the songs you ever wrote, which is the one you're proud of most?
Oh, man.
It's a tough one, Matt.
That is a tough one because they're all good. And as it gets louder, I'm gonna talk louder. It's another McDonald's.
Oh, God. Okay, what about our final video before we hit the Astoria and and start doing some live stuff and looking at your catering and dressing rooms and seeing what you have on your rider.
What was the question?
Oh, don't worry, I'll ask him. What video do you want us to play, Vicar?
The Painkiller, Judas Priest.
Coming up. We've shown Slayer the beautiful city that is London, and we've actually sold them 92% of it, and we're hoping to pick up the cash later. So it's been a very fruitful thing having them on the top of the bus and having a good time. But there is work to do for these guys. There is work to do. They've got to hit the stage, and they have got to perform. And you're going to see some of the performance as well here tonight on the Friday Rock Show. Slayer at the Astoria in London, delivering like they deliver, like nobody else can, with speed, precision, and with impact, and with, well, you know. Hey, guys, we're at the Astoria now. If you want to come down, sir, can you open the door for us? Thank you very much indeed. This is where you have to work. Enough of this nonsense, you know, of you guys, having a good time. Get out there. Come on, Tom, come on. Please, Tom.
All right.
Kerry, thanks very much for coming on the bus, and we'll see you later.
No worries.
It's very nice of you. We appreciate that.
Thanks for selling me on London.
It's a great pleasure. We'll have it boxed up for you and sent just as soon as possible.
That's cool. Then you have to come see it.
What, sorry?
Then you have to come see it.
Oh, come on. Yeah, it'll all be in your yard, won't it?
Yeah, I'll set it up pretty cool.
Okay, fine. Well, thanks a lot.
All right. Appreciate
it. If you want to buy any T-shirts or anything like
Let
that, any sort of merchandising, there's lots of merchandising in here.
I'll get back with you.
Okay. if you'd like to buy the whole theater, Kerry, it's a possibility too. No, we'll clean it up for you a little bit.
Well, that would be pretty cool.
Okay.
Well, I can deal with that.
Looks like we kind of sold that to him. Did you get that? We sold him the theater. But now, I think it's time for some real serious stuff. Let's see what happens backstage at a real rock and roll gig. Follow me. Hi, who have you come to see?
Slayer, Sepultura, System of a Down, Hall 3.
Well, that's very convenient because they're on. And you're still with the Friday Rock Show here on VH1. Yeah, we got him here. We got him into the building. They're here in one piece. We're here in one piece. And the show is now going to continue with some live performance as well as some video performance as well. I'm really happy to be in this building because so many amazing rock bands have been on the stage here at the Astoria in London. If you don't live in London, you live somewhere else and you've never been here, let me tell you, this is one of the premier rock venues in the whole world. But enough of this spiel. Let's get in there and see what it's like. At a sound check. Follow me! Thanks very much. So here we are at a sound check. This is what happens at a sound check. You just get people on the stage giving it some of that. They give it some of that for one specific reason, because over there's a blooming great desk where all the things are plugged into to make sure that the sound is good. What do you mean I'm stating the obvious? What do you mean you knew that in the first instance? Sorry. Kerry, once you've done the sound check, what do you do then? Go back to sleep?
No, sleeping's usually over by then. usually we check earlier. Yeah, but we had to wait for some people today. I don't know, after that, we do any press in the day. And this is all I have to do today, I think. So I'm hanging with you.
Have you any idea how many people are involved in your crew?
Our crew? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I think there's 7, I think.
But would that include lighting and sound and everything?
Yeah, our own lighting guy. And then you got the local guys. We got, like, European people to set up the lights for our lighting, our own lighting guy. And European PA people and people that set up the monitors and the front of house mix and stuff. And then we got our own guys dial it in.
The one thing that I really have to do now is eat! I want to eat, Gary! I haven't eaten all day long and I don't want a McDonald's.
Yeah, we were supposed to go there. What happened?
We didn't go. I mean, but now can we eat, Gary?
I don't know, but I can point us in the direction.
Now, Kerry, you're going to take me, I hope, backstage, meet some people?
Yeah, we could do that. Let's get out of this stinky stairway we're in. This place, this building reeks. Anybody that's ever been here knows.
But it stinks. It stinks.
Every room has its own stink, though. They're all different.
Stinks of what?
I don't know.
Just stinks.
I'm not a stink connoisseur, it just reeks.
Get a specialist in later, we'll find out what's wrong with the place. Okay, through door one, on the way up to the stage. The stairs. That bit kind of reminds me of a prison. Yeah? That bit there. Kind of like an institution. up these stairs here and onto the stage. Oh, which is jammed with material. Absolutely jammed.
Will be famous?
Hey, this is our monitor guy, Rick Deesing. He makes sure we can hear on stage and blast my ears nightly.
Okay, hold on for a second.
Hi.
Hi, how you doing?
And hi, he certainly is. He's a tall man. And he does the monitors, right? How many monitors do you have? These are all these things down here.
My two, Tom's got the front four, Jeff's two, got side fills right here. Fill up all the rest of the parts where we can't hear. This is the guy who takes care of my axes. This is Danny.
Danny. Or
Borga, you can call him Borga, he likes that.
How many guitars does he actually sort of go to?
In this set, three different ones.
And what's the, maybe they're all different makes, but what's the actual variant? Why does he need three? Why not one? Keep it cheap.
He likes three.
Straight answer.
Well, we also have different tunings. For the first couple songs, we have low tunings, and then for the rest of the songs, we have a normal tuning, which is a D sharp. So I can tune them up, because they go out of tune a lot during the show.
Is that because he whacks them?
That, plus it gets really humid, and it's really hot, and it makes the strings go flat. So, and then sometimes you'll get a cold breeze, and it makes them go sharp. So it never really stays.
Okay. Is he a good guitarist?
Yeah.
So there you go. That's what the guitar tech does. We've seen the monitor man. What else have we got up here?
We've got Norm, the drum guy.
Hi, Norm.
Hello.
Welcome to the United Kingdom.
Want to be famous?
You want to be famous, Norm?
Always.
Okay, tell us something American.
Tell us something American.
Yes, sir.
This place sucks.
This place sucks. That's nice, and that's before the show. Thank you, Norman. Thank you very much. Is he like that all the time?
Oh, Norm's great.
He thinks
Norm
it sucks,
and Rick,
right?
And our lighting guy, add for mass comic relief.
We actually do love your country.
You have to keep it light.
And all the girls in it. I must
admit. And they love you.
The women here are fabulous.
They are, actually. They're very nice English women, aren't they? But don't you sort of get mixed up with the accent sometimes? Because, or does everything mean the same?
Well, Randy has a different term in our Randy's a little different, I guess. Knickers, those kind of things, a little different, but they're all girls.
He's got a smile on his face, so he must be happy. And anybody else? What else is happening up here? Really?
Yeah, we're doing changeover because in this place, the stage is so small, we got to take Paul's drums down, which we usually don't. We usually leave his up, put Sepultura's in front, but there's no room in this place, so we got to strike drums every night. It's kind of a pain in the ass. We don't usually do that, but, make it work for both bands so everybody gets the best out of the stage.
Amazing place. It's seriously amazing old theater this is. It's like a labyrinth. You go down one stair and up another stair and then find a door and go through that door and find another door and it's difficult to get around. Through this door, though, there's a band and there's Kerry as well from Slayer, and he's going to introduce us to one of the bands on the bill, so step this way. Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you don't mind if I bring the camera crew in and all that stuff. This is my camera, and this is another door. See, I told you, door after door after door. Kerry, where are we? What's happening? I'm scared. Excuse me,
sir.
Jump in there.
We are in System of a Down's dressing room. This is our Aussie bloke right here. I think he's working tour manager for these guys.
Yes, he is.
Which, this gentleman, you the tour manager, sir?
Yeah, that's what they call me.
Okay, but is it what you is?
No, that's me, that's me.
That's you. Yeah. Okay, but can you introduce us to the guys?
Chavo, Clockwork Orange. Serge, the resident terrorist. Darren back there, guitar man. John, plays sticks.
And we're talking about System of?
A Down.
Which is what? For those who aren't in the know, System of a Down, what is it?
What is it? I don't know, what is it? Must mean something.
Okay, well, excuse me, what does it mean?
Right here.
This guy here.
Open to interpretations, what is it to you?
That's it.
Can't say fairer than that. Obviously a harmony band, I'd say. Yeah, they're the Beach Boys of the 90s, ladies and gentlemen.
Watchman and tell him how that go of a song, the mouthy's all a gentile or a priest who victored over the Seljuks when the hood
we come down to what's known as catering. Who does your catering? Who's in charge? Have you got a catering chef?
Catering guru?
A guru.
He just ran off.
My name's Dorian. It's me and Matt are together on this route to be doing the cooking in the dressing rooms and being male mothers, basically.
Can you describe some of the food for us? Would you mind?
I have no idea.
Well, give us a description anyway. What do you say?
It's some kind of British sandwich stuff and...
Ham. Carry
yeah,
ham.
But you guys got a different way of making sandwiches here. I remember when we used to come over in the early days, what was it? Butter and cheese might be a sandwich, and butter and ham might be a sandwich. But it's always a lot of butter and whatever, a little bit of whatever else.
We give them whatever they want. They have the choice. They can come in at any time and ask for it. If we can't do it, we just tell them to get stuffed.
What do you have here?
Probably coffee and tea, I would imagine.
That should be Jim Beam, Jack Daniels, and Maker's Mark, shouldn't it?
No, we're going to have a big tub of vodka someplace.
That's the tub of vodka.
All right. That works. With a okay. ladle in it. My vodka's curdling.
Dinner's up. This is where it lives.
Oh, looks like this is an oriental one tonight, I think.
That part's rice. These are empty. Not done yet. What the hell's in here? Huh? Chicken.
Chicken.
We found the chicken. Tortilla chips here. Let me open this thing.
Okay. If we keep that open for too long, the chicken will jump out.
That's not hot.
Secrets. The secrets are being revealed. Yet another location. Yet another destination. And yet more people. Hello, people.
Hello.
They tell me your name is Stamp Anything.
That's correct.
But Mary Jo Stamp Anything.
Ms. Mary Jo Stamp Anything.
Ms. Mary Jo Stamp Anything. But you are the tour manager.
Yes, I am.
These hairy people, man. These big hairy men. How do you get them to respond to you?
I just ignore them.
You've learned, huh? How long have you been doing this tour managing stuff?
For Slayer or in general?
In general.
Almost 5 years.
Good gig?
Yeah, for the most part.
How'd you get into it? Do you have to pass an examination or something?
Be in the right place at the right time.
And what was the place and what was the time?
I wish I could tell you.
Before the audience get into the auditorium and start really mushing it up, because that's what a Slayer audience does, I like to talk to a gentleman who keeps them under control. He's one of the team of security men here at the Astoria. His name is Neville, but he does it with a slightly different twist. Neville, I'd like to know the secret of your success in the arena of being a security geezer.
Right, okay, the secret is just letting people have a very good time. I like to call people over because in the past they've had a lot of security that like to thump the kids as they come over. And all they want to do is have a good time. My idea of having a good time is let them surf. You know, if they want to get on the stage, you let them get on the stage. It's not a problem for us. The band actually deals with that. They've got their own personal security up there to deal with that. At the end of the day, they're not causing a problem. The band like people coming up, having a good time, right, and jumping off. And that's what we're here for. Let them surf, let them enjoy the show, because it's all part of rock music. And I too like rock, because I'm a rock fanatic.
My head is going round and round in circles, and yet the whole sort of episode isn't over. We did the bus, we went around London, we sold them half of London, right? Unfortunately, I don't think I can get it all in the box, and I don't think they've got the cash for Buckingham Palace and Trafalgar Square and all that other stuff I was trying to sell them. We had the hotel, went to the hotel, and then we went backstage to see exactly how the thing actually works and functions. But now it's all going to slightly change here on the Friday Rock Show from the Astoria in London. What we're up for now is exactly what you're up for now, except I'm here and you ain't, but I'll try and get across the atmosphere to you. We're up for some live music, some stunning live rock music. First, this is System of a Down.
Hello, London! The home of Jack the Ripper!
Slayer in the States as well, and in some areas especially, it's harder than others because they're like the heaviest band, you know, to open for. I always said if we can open up for Slayer, we could be on Lilith Fair. We could do anything.
We could fly.
More stairs, 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 and more stairs. Following Kerry around the backstage area. Yeah, at the...
Actually,
yes.
This may be the only time you get to meet Jeff all night, so here you go.
This is not Jeff Hanneman.
Yeah.
Where's you been hiding? I haven't been left... I mean, I saw you earlier today at the lobby of the hotel. Since then, absolutely nothing. You hang out with the liquor or what?
No, actually, I do not. Hey, you know where I went today? I went to the War Museum.
You went to the Imperial War Museum.
Yeah.
How was it?
It was pretty awesome. That place was a lot bigger than I thought it was. I mean, they had a lot of tanks, and they had the plane. Have you been there?
Mm.
Yeah, the planes hanging from the ceiling. That place was huge. It was pretty impressive.
But is that the type of thing that you particularly do when you hit a big city? Do you look for museums or stuff?
I've been to this one now, and I went to the one in Munich, and that's pretty much all I've been to because we don't have a lot of time to go out and look at these things. Because if we have a day off, we're usually sleeping. If not, then, you know, we're sleeping again. But we don't have a lot of time.
There's none better than Slayer, right? There's none better. I just don't care what anyone says. There's fucking none better than Slayer, right?
A lot of people, I mean, I've heard people say this to my face because they know I've been associated with rock music for such a long time. Bands like Slayer, they just play fast. They just play fast. They don't have any skill.
I'd like to see them do what we do, especially in the slower bands. I'd like to see them get up on stage and, come on, try this. We'll show you how it goes. Give it a shot.
The amount of energy that you put into performance is immense.
Oh, yeah. It's a lot of fun, though. I mean, we've been doing it for years, and it's just it's a good release.
They're blinding. Best metal band ever.
And when you go home, what do you listen to?
Kind of nothing that really sounds like us. More softer type bands. Not totally soft, but, you know, like Kilgore, you know, stuff like that, STP, stuff like that, basically.
So nothing like the Beatles' White Album?
Oh, nothing that soft, no. Can't stand that music.
Hard man, hard man. Ladies and gentlemen, Jeff Hanneman from Slayer, please. Come on. Applause.
Hey.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Slayer, just in case you hadn't noticed, are a four-piece band. We found three of them.
The three musicians.
Oh, come on, you're a drummer, man.
Exactly.
Oh, that's enough of that interview. I'll see you. How long have you been with the band? Because you're not the original.
Not the original, but I started playing with the guys in 92.
That makes you original enough, though, man. That's long enough.
Yeah. They were around for 10 years before that. So they started jamming with another guy, left the band for a brief period of time, and came back for this record.
Okay. Fast on those feet.
It's fast music.
Tiring?
It is and it isn't. You know, I mean, when we first start playing, it's, when you're not in tour shape, you know, it can be tiring. But, you know, at the end of the tour, you get pretty much into it. So, you know, you get used to it.
Is there any latitude in the way that you play drums with Slayer that allows you to do slightly different things? Or do you have to stay right on it?
Oh, wow. There's not really much room for improvisation. Mm. You know, things are going so fast that if you don't, you know, I change parts just based upon, you know, just the performance of the evening, but I don't go out of my way to do any kind of, like, you know, what I like to call stony improvisational parts, because that'll just throw everybody off. So
on top of that, it's like three against one, isn't it?
Well, no, not really, because, I mean, you know, if it's three against one, then we wouldn't sound very good live, you know. So we're all in tune.
Don't have to take what I say seriously, you know.
I take everything seriously.
Because he's a drummer.
That's right.
See you on stage.
All right, man. Thanks. Take it easy.
Thank you, sir. Three bands on the bill. We've yet to meet a band that originated in Brazil. Though they're not entirely Brazilian, are they, now?
No, they got the new singer, Derek, and I don't know where he's from, but he's American.
Okay. You want to take me in there?
Yeah, better hold your hand, right?
Well, you know how it is when you're a VJ. Okay, let's get into this dressing room and finally meet Sepultura. Hey. Hello, Sepultura. Hey. All I can say in Brazilian is Mashkenada. About all I know. Welcome, welcome.
Thank you. Welcome to our Titanic dressing room.
It's a good dressing room. Can I just ask you to stand up, sir?
Sure.
I know you don't want to do that.
Let me just. Oh, I don't know if I can fit in the camera.
Oh my God! He just broke my shoulder.
Tell him you liked him better in the first movie.
I loved you, you were great, Mr. Weissmuller.
Now things are different, you know.
Mr. Schwarzenegger.
I moved on to bigger and better things, yeah.
Where are you from?
I'm from America.
Okay, then we'll give you that one, because you used to be a football player.
No, never. I tried out for a football team when I was really young, but it was a Catholic school, and I wasn't Catholic, so they kicked me off. So I decided never to play again.
You started to become a rock and roller?
Yep, basically.
How's it going with Sepultura now?
Very good. The shows have been great. This is the last show. I'm really excited. Should be a good show.
Okay. Do you speak Brazilian yet?
Brazilian? Portuguese?
Português.
Boquinho, yeah.
He's on it.
Yeah, good.
The guy's on it. How's the tour
going? It's going great. Mm-hmm. It's really good, except the weather. English weather.
This is England.
Yeah,
yeah. God's sake, you know.
We're not coming back here.
Ever.
No, never again. Never.
This is it, ladies and gentlemen.
We're going to stay in Brazil forever now.
It's your last chance. Have a good show. Thank you very much indeed for your time.
Thank you, man.
I appreciate it.
All right.
And please don't go out.
Jesus.
Woo, the man big. Big, I tell you.
Does rock and roll via a program called The Friday Rock Show.
Oh my God, you don't watch it, do you?
What I want you to do just for me right now, if you will please, is make a crap load of noise, because we need a sound check. On a count of three. One, two, three. That was crap. But this is gonna be the one! One, two, three! Enjoy the show! Give it some steak! Mush your nuts off!
You have got Slayer still to come, but right now you've got the band who really come out of Brazil and give it some massive welly! Sepultura, 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 Sepultura. What was the Brazilian music scene like when you were growing up? Was it heavy? What did you listen to?
Actually, no. That's the reason we started playing this kind of music in Brazil. We're pretty much sick of all the Brazilian music that was going around for years and years. So we decided to do something different at the time in Brazil, which is mix like heavy metal and death metal at the time and hardcore. So make like extreme music in Brazil. So that was the main reason we start playing this whole music. It was just boredom of all the Brazilian like rhythms.
What bands did you listen to though? And if in fact, was it easy to get hold of the music that you liked in Brazil?
Not really. It was very difficult. I mean, I started listening to Kiss, Queen, and then got heavier to Iron Maiden, and then heavier to Metallica and Celtic Frost. But at the beginning, like in early 80s, was very difficult to find. It was more like one store in São Paulo, which like have all the import albums, very expensive. So we kind of used to like collect money from everybody and buy one album and then make copies for everybody, you know? It was kind of like a gang, really, you know? It was just a few people who knew those bands, and was like bootleg tapes all around to get the stuff, you know?
When you got your band together, when you got Sepultura together, in terms of audience reaction, what was it like first off? Who would come and see you? What sort were they sort of revolutionary as you were that inspired you to get out there and thrash it up a bit?
Well, Igor can say better about that stuff because they start Sepultura in Belo Horizonte, but at the same time I was in another town starting my own band. So I just like play covers, you know, from Venom to Twisted Sister, but we all play like the stuff that we like. And just like started as a friends in school and stuff, you know, we gather together, listen to the same kind of music, play like in very small clubs, school parties, you know, stuff like that. And little by little, like with big festivals in Brazil, Rock in Rio, and then Hollywood Rock, you know, big bands have the chance to come to Brazil and you have the chance to see them live.
In Brazil, Sepultura is what I would call a revered name. I mean, it really is you're a national monument in Brazil.
Yeah, I mean, respect, I think it's the main word that goes around with Sepultura. It goes from old people all the way to young kids. They really respect Sepultura because we pretty much represent Brazil
in a very positive way outside of Brazil. So when you hear of Sepultura, it usually involves a lot of pride on it.
Great footballers, good musicians.
Great to be back here, man, on Disturbed Night in fucking Astoria, man. I'd like to introduce here our new singer, Derek Green!
Top of the bill. The guys that we took on the bus, the guys that we showed London to, and the guys, I have to say, who gave us an enormous amount of complete sort of freedom. In fact, I think it's time for a band by the name of Slayer. Does anybody agree with that? Excuse me. Would you like to hear Slayer?
Yeah.
Well, there's a man of great enthusiasm.
I think they're fucking cool, man. Sorry for swearing, but they're cool.
You like the what?
Bee Gees.
Forget it. This is Slayer!
Thank you very much. Thank you. And welcome back! Did you guys have a good week? Fucking A, that's good. All right, man. Listen, we're gonna do one off of Show No Mercy for you. Since we're all feeling a little wicked tonight. This is Evil Has No Boundaries!
think it's time to get in the dressing room and pay final respects. Follow me. Gentlemen, 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 gentlemen. Just one word. Respect.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Respect.
Thank you, Tommy.
Thank you. Respect.
Thank you.
And respect. Ladies and gentlemen, I want from you out there, wherever you happen to be, from Estonia to South Africa, from Israel to Paris, to give a round of applause to Slayer on a count of three. Yes!
The stage is the best time of the day.
In any city.
In any city, any country, in any day.
Well, what is that stupid cliche? All good things must come to an end. It's been a long day. We've been all around London. We've been in our dressing rooms. We've been and seen the catering. We've been all over the place. We've seen the gig. We've seen the live bands. And I'm completely and utterly knackered. And you are probably too, having watched a show here on VH1. Just like to say thanks very much to all the bands. I think they're incredible the way they get up there and give out so much energy. And I'd like to thank you very much for watching VH1 and the Friday Rock Show. Wherever you happen to be, you take care of yourself. My name is Tommy Vance, and I'm out of here and out of it. Good night.